guys, welcome back to a new Women in STEM video. And in today's video, we are going to be talking about Joan Elizabeth Murray. Joan was an English cryptanalyst that worked at Berchley Park during the Second World War in the Enigma project. She was portrayed by Keira Knightley in the movie The Imitation Game. Before we start, just a short disclaimer. I am not a historian, I'm not a biographer or history student or anything of the kind. All the information that I'm saying here in this video, it's information that I've found in the internet after doing some research. And I am terrible at pronouncing names. So if I say one or two surnames wrong or something like this, forgive me. Okay, with this being said, let's get started. Joan Murray was born on 24th of June 1917 in London, England. In 1936, Joan got a scholarship to study mathematics at the Newnham College in Cambridge, and she was a wrangler in the last year. A wrangler is a student at the University of Cambridge that earns first honors degrees at the end of their studies in mathematics. However, even though she was a wrangler and a pretty good student, of course, a full degree was denied to her because Cambridge would, until 1948, award those only to men. Full degrees were only awarded to women after the Second World War. During a geometry class, one of Joan's supervisors, William Gordon Welshman, notice her abilities, her mathematical skills. William was one of the top four mathematicians recruited in 1939 to supervise the coding operations at the Berchley Park, the principal center of Allied forces for code-breaking operations during the Second World War. Almost two-thirds of all the people working at Berchley Park at the time were women, and they would work as interceptor communicators, punch card operators, transcriber, linguist, typists, you name it, administrators, secretaries, and so on and so forth. William Welshman recruited her to be part of the Government Code and Cipher School, GCCS, which had a single purpose, to break the German Enigma code. He also told her that actually mathematics wasn't that big deal, it wasn't really necessary to perform this job, but mathematicians tend to perform well in this job, which require imagination and accurate thinking. The biggest part of mathematics in this role would be focusing on statistics and probability. Like all the other women working at Berchley, she was assigned to work with the girls. That's how they were called. They weren't women, they were the girls. She works mostly with clerical work, and she was paid £2 a week. That's at the time would be like $8 a week, which was much lower than her counterparts, her male counterparts. In a week, or even less than that, Alan Turing noticed her abilities and skills and recruited her to work with him at the Hut 8 instead of working with Welshman's at the Hut 6. The Hut 8 was occupied by Alan Turing, Tony Kendrick, Peter Twin, and some others. In order to be paid for her promotion, after she accepted moving from the Hut 6 to the Hut 8 with Alan Turing, Joan actually had a contract as a linguist, because there were no protocols or contracts at the time for a senior female cryptanalyst. In the Hut 8, she became the only practitioner of Bamburismus, a cryptoanalytic process developed by Alan Turing to decipher the German encrypted messages. She would then use this method, Bamburismus, to decipher encrypted messages by the German Enigma machine in real time, one of the most high-pressure jobs at Berchley's. The Germans actually believed that this machine was unbreakable. For them, it was just impossible. The machine would change the letters in specific manners, in complex manners, depending on a daily changing key. and this key could have more than 150 trillion possible settings. So it was like, it sounds impossible to find out what the setting is so they could decodify the message. During her time there at Bletchley, she actually got closer and closer to Alan Turing, and people say that they were mentally wise very similar, and that made they get closer very fast. In the spring of 1941, he proposed to her, and yeah, Joan was very surprised by that, you know, because they never had any physical contact before. But she was pretty excited, she liked him, so she said yes, why not, right? She just said yes, and on the next day, he came to her and he told her that he actually was an homosexual. She acted pretty normal to it. She said that she already expected, maybe because he never tried to go physical on her. There's only two possibilities, right? Or the guy is very, very, very too nice. I don't even know if you can say that. He was just too nice, or something is wrong. So she already suspected that something was wrong, but at the time, it would be complicated. He couldn't say this to anyone, right? It was very harsh times, and he had to hide in order to keep his profession, his job and everything. So if he would marry a woman, actually, that would be pretty good for him. People would be less suspicious about it. I don't know, but she liked him. She said yes, and they just kept going. But it didn't last long though. After some months, he broke up the engagement because he just didn't believe that it was going to work anyway. But it still, they kept friends. They were friends until the very end, until his death in 1954. And she kept, she had warm feelings for him throughout her whole life. Afterwards. In 1944, she was promoted deputy head of Hood 8, but she was actually prevented from progressing because of her gender. She just couldn't be promoted any higher than that, and she was also still being paid much less than the men, and also working at the same level or below. After the war, she went to work at Bletchley's successor organization, the Government Communication Headquarters, GCHQ, and there she met the Lieutenant Colonel Murray, and she married him in 1952. And look at this, in 1947, she was appointed a member of the British Empire for her code-breaking work. That's an honor. Joan was a lady. She was a lady in the tradition of her days. She was congenial, but shy and kind and gentle, truthful, non-aggressive and agreeable to all, to subordinates and to the men in her life, except in Hood 8, where she was seen as an equal. Unfortunately, due to the secrecy surrounding all the events at Berchley Park, it's still hard to uncover all the extent of her work in there, of all her achievements. It still remains unknown. However, it's clear that her work on the naval Enigma project helped to shorten the war and saved thousands of lives. In my personal opinion, she remains an example to women nowadays. Be strong, be passionate, follow your ambitions, but still stay humble and gentle and kind and feminine. You don't have to act like a man in order to gain respect from anyone. And that's it for today's video. I do hope you enjoy it. Like the video if you did. Don't forget to subscribe, turn on the notifications so you don't miss any new content, and I see you next time. Bye!